This is a TinyWhoop FPV racing gate, so that instead of strapping on your goggles, powering up your TinyWhoop, completing the best circuit of your amateur racing career, and then...
Finished! What was my time?
If you've seen my first ever YouTube video, you'll know that I've actually built a TinyWhoop FPV racing gate before. In fact, it looked a little something like this. Now this racing gate does its job, and it does it pretty well. It can tell when a drone goes through, and it'll either start or stop the race, indicated by this snazzy LED ring, which also doubles as an excellent backlight.
The new design has the same bones, ultrasonic sensors for detecting distance, which works by emitting high frequencies and measuring how long it takes to return. Though I am experimenting with light sensors, which could prove to be a more reliable way as they're able to emit more pings per second than an ultrasonic sensor, but that's to be continued. When a drone passes through the gate, the sound from the ultrasonic bounces off the drone back to the sensor, which is how I'm able to detect if something has passed through. Another returning feature is the LED ring, which is a programmable WS2182B RGB strip, which is super easy to work with thanks to the available code library. The new design centers around this brilliant 2.4-inch touchscreen display, which adds the interactive capabilities missing in the older model, which featured a plain 4-digit display. Incorporating the touchscreen into the design was mechanically simple, as I just redesigned the housing to fit it, but the code to use it, not so much.
But hey, that's why I'm here. Spend countless hours staring into the void of my computer screen, questioning my life choices.
What am I doing with my life?
On the screen, you'll see three buttons: settings, results, and the racing control, which cycles between start, stop, and reset. Under settings, you'll find the option to select the number of racers ranging from 1 to 5, and the number of laps 1 to 8. This gate is intended for one person, but the capability for multiple racers is there. Under results, you'll see all the times displayed with the corresponding racer number and lap.
The screen now sits at a nice 45 degree angle, making it actually possible to see the time from the viewfinder of your drone without ever having to get up from your couch or chair.
For those of you who are already sold, everything you will need to build one of these is in the description below, which includes wiring diagrams, 3D models, the code, parts, etc. But while it is possible to wire everything physically, like I did in my first design, I designed a custom circuit board that makes the gate way more reliable and easy to assemble. Though I realize not everyone is going to want to order 20 circuit boards from China to build this, or maybe you just want the results without spending hours building one of your own. Because of this, I've decided to do a small production run, which you can pre-order through the link below or by going to professorboots.com.
This gate is in development and very much a prototype, so I'd appreciate any and all feedback, as well as a bit of patience if any bugs arise. Once I have a rough estimate on demand, which will take about 2 weeks from the posting of this video, I will order everything, assemble, and get them shipped out to you as soon as possible. Keep in mind, all assembly, shipping, and packaging is done by yours truly.
To get it ready, all you do is take it out, stand it up, press the tubing into the holes on each side, and then plug in your favorite 2S, 3S, or 4S LiPo battery. And yes, you did hear that right. This unit of a racing gate can run off a tiny 2S battery all the way up to a 4S. I recommend using a large 2-cell battery, but as you see here, I'm powering it off a 4S 1500 milliamp battery, no problem.
Now that your cherry unit of a racing gate is assembled, it's time to go from a zero to a hero. We've come so far, and I haven't even mentioned the best part. Wireless connection.
Oh. If you go to the settings page, you'll see an IP address displayed mid-screen. Using your phone, TV, laptop, or your crusty old Nintendo DS from middle school, you'll find that address displayed under your Wi-Fi connections. Connect to it, open a browser, and type that same IP address. You now have yourself an external monitor.
This way, it won't just be you knowing how much of a stud you are, but everyone else will now know too. It's also way easier to see the time from the drone. One thing to keep in mind if you are racing with other people is the gate currently doesn't have the capability to differentiate between drones, so it can get a little bit confused if somebody's lapping other people. I'm working on a couple solutions this very moment. Well, not this very moment, because I'm filming this video for you lovely people this very moment, but, well, you get the point. They're on the way, they'll be posted in Discord.
What I recommend is setting your phone or camera next to the gate. This way you can go back through and watch whose drones flew through and in what order. Using the gate's results page, you can then match the times up.
All right, I'm gonna go ahead and do a quick demonstration race. All I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into settings. I'm gonna change it to 2 laps instead of 1. I'm not gonna change the number of racers because it's just me racing right now. Go back to main, and then we're good to go. I'm gonna go ahead and power up my TinyWhoop. To start the race, all I'm gonna do is fly through. Now the race has started. Go do a lap. So that would be lap 1. That's lap 2. I'm sure there'll be lots of questions on how to build this, or perhaps I'll release an update in the future which will result in additional features, as well as more questions. My response to this is this brand new Tribe of Boots Discord server, where people can ask their questions and get responses, as well as help solve any issues that myself or anybody else is having with any project that they're working on. I encourage you to check it out, as my favorite part about any of this YouTube stuff is hearing about what projects you guys are working on or things that you'd like to see made in the future. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope this racing gate helps you train so that you can wipe the floors with your fellow TinyWhoop buddies at your next big race.